And therefore, open to me from the Gospel of Luke. Luke chapter 2. Luke chapter 2,
Luke chapter 2, 8 to 14.
And I'm going to read you some foundational scriptures. And then we'll go to Isaiah. Luke chapter 2 from 8 to 14. The Bible says, now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock at by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings. Amen. Has somebody had NIV somewhere? What did it say in NIV, that part?
I bring you good news.
I bring you good news. Say good news.
Good tidings.
I bring you good tidings of great joy. Say great joy.
Great joy.
Which will be for all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. We will know later why they call him Christ the Lord. And then the other foundational scripture that I want to read to you is Isaiah chapter 9. Isaiah chapter 9 verse 2. And then from 6 to 7. So the Bible says, the people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwell in the shadow of the in the land of the shadow of death, upon them a light has shined. And I'm jumping to verse 6, says, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. Upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, to order it and establish it with judgment and justice from that time forward, even forever. The seal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I told you earlier that in every Christmas, as people call by faith and people set apart, when we worship before in the camp until today, we know that there is no other way we can dance and jump only when we come to God's presence. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
And so because we have left everything, we don't go to nightclub anymore. We don't go to disco anymore. And therefore, if we don't dance in the Lord, there'll be now we can dance.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Today, most of you who have come today, you are blessed. There are many parties going out there. And those parties will end up, some people will go to prison. You will be home. There will be lots of gossiping there. There will be lots of hatred. There will be lots of division.
But
you people who have come to hear this morning, God bless you. And therefore
Christmas
is a time of celebration and happiness. We must just remember that Jesus is the reason for the season.
Amen. Hallelujah.
In our office in right here, our supervisors from Bosnia, and she's Muslim. Most of the workers there, we work with the Arabic people who come from Middle East.
And
so most of them who work with me, they are Muslim. And they ask me, do you celebrate Christmas? I say, do you celebrate Christmas? And they say, we don't celebrate, but we enjoy the holiday. And the world wants to tell it to be happy holiday. And when I told them, I said, happy Christmas.
Amen.
Because Jesus is the reason for the season. Without Jesus, there will be no Christmas. People were doing a lot of shopping in Red
Deer.
We have two big malls in Red
Deer.
We have the Parkland Mall,
the Parkland Mall,
and the Bar Mall.
And the Bar Mall.
And people in the Bar Mall will have the bay and all this stuff. And then I went to do some shopping. Yes, must have been true. I couldn't find a good shirt. And I went to find a village. And I got this shirt. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's from Valley Village. There are good things from Valley
Village.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm here preaching from Valley Village. And the suit I'm wearing today is a gift from the man of God. The suit I'm wearing is a gift from Juba. So I did not spend any money
today.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Master
the Lord is good. And therefore, the good news that I want to preach to you today. The good news of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I'm going to center my messages into 7 points. So I want you to bear with me. And I want you to understand that you will never hear these messages throughout January, only the time of Christmas. One of the messages I want to tell you today is about deep darkness. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verse 2, it says, the people walking in darkness have seen a great light. People who are living in the shadow of death,
the
light has shined upon them. When we live in darkness, oh, Jesus will be out of our whole environment. And therefore, we need Jesus as the only good news to come in. When people live in darkness, this means we have turned our back unto the Lord. When we live in darkness, means we have become to rely on our own reason. We become to rely on our own thinking. We become to rely on our own desires. And darkness will take over. Darkness gets into our lives the moment we reject God. The moment we disobey God. That's what the Bible says, people walking in darkness. So it's like, I wish somebody could turn off all these lights.
Right?
And then you will understand what I mean by darkness. Do you understand darkness, by the way? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Darkness. When you walk in darkness, the Lord will not be with you. And the devil will take over. Because human beings are not alone. Either you're with the devil in darkness, or you are with Jesus in the light. And therefore we are not alone. And therefore when you are in the darkness, you will do things that people will say, go with
you.
You will do things and people will say, like the Bible speaker, the Bible speaker will say, what a lawyer corner. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. When you do things in darkness, you sometimes will not even know, because the devil will blind your face so you cannot see the light. Then you begin to insist. You become stubborn. When someone is telling you that my sister, my brother, this is wrong, you become furious and angry. Why? Because it's the work of the enemy. And therefore, the devil takes over and he charges church of your life. This is darkness. But the good news is, in this deep darkness, God is waiting for opportunity. God is just waiting for opportunity. When you just step out, even of the little darkness, even out of the little light, you just begin to see.
لما تطلع من الظلام بس حتى النور صغير جدا.
Jesus will grab you out.
يسوع بيمسك الطوالي.
Jesus grab you from the darkness.
يسوع بيشيل من الظلام الطوالي.
And today I'm in the light.
لأن أنا موجود في النور.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is called Emmanuel.
يسوع بيرا اسمه إيمانويل.
He lives with us.
هو عايش معنا.
He knows your darkness.
هو بيعرف الظلام بتاعنا.
He knows my darkness.
هو بيعرف الظلام بتاعنا.
And therefore come to the light.
شديد تعال إلى النور.
He will not be against you.
ما بكون ضدك.
He will always come to you and take you to the light.
هو always بيجيك وبيشيل من الظلام إلى النور.
And Jesus never hates you.
ما بيكره.
Jesus only hates the work of the devil.
يسوع بكرامة الشيطان.
And that's the reason why he came.
لسبب هو جاء.
And therefore that's why Isaiah prophesied.
شديد إشياء يتنبأ.
To the people of Israel.
يتنبأ لبني إسرائيل.
They have been darkened in darkness.
كانوا تقول الظلمة في الظلام.
And they've been waiting for breakthrough.
كانوا تعايزين كانوا تشهد رمى الظلام
وكان Jesus came.
كان يسوع جاء.
That's why when he came.
لما يسوع جاء.
And he said, I am the light of the world.
يسوع كان نور العالم.
The second point.
النقطة الثانية.
Jesus the light of the world.
يسوع نور العالم.
It's mentioned in the book of Isaiah.
مكتوب في أشعياء.
Chapter 9 verse 2.
أصحاح 9 عدد 2.
That the light has shined in darkness.
كان النور ولا في الظلام.
And when Jesus came.
كان من يسوع جاء.
He fulfilled the prophecy.
وأكمل النبوة.
And he said in the book of John chapter 8 verse 1.
وكان في إنجيل يوحنا فتر على 14.
Do you want to read this?
ممكن تقرأ معي؟
Jesus said, I am the light of the world. And those who follow me shall never walk in darkness. Somebody shout amen. I tell you, brothers and sisters, the functions of light, the functions, the work of light. Light is very important in our life.
نور مهم جدا في حياتنا.
Light is very important in our life.
نور مهم جدا في حياتنا.
You know, I came to Cuba some few months ago.
أنا جيت من جوبا قبل كم شهر.
When my dad passed away.
لما أبوي توفى.
And I knew, I see around, I have my older brother.
أنا دي أخوي أبوي كبير.
But for whatever reason, the family sat down.
كل أسرة قعدت.
And I was given responsibility of the whole family.
وأنا مسؤول كله بتاع الأسرة
فيها. And I told them.
أنا قلت
I'm even struggling with my own family.
أنا قلت له أنا ما عندي مشاكل الأسرة بتاعي.
But you know what?
كان أنا ليكي.
I realized one night.
أنا قعدت مع الشيء شو كان.
As we sleep one night.
نقول نايم.
Every time when you sleep in the house, when there's any problem, when there's anything that is suspicious, my dad comes out. And now my dad was not there. And I heard there's something like walking in the house. And I said, now since I'm the dad here, let me go out. I took my torch. I have a torch in my Samsung phone. Which is a very big light. I put the light on. And my mom came and grabbed the thing with my mom and said, do you want to be killed? I said, my dad used to do that before.
Because
I want to see what is there. When you come to the light of Jesus, you will see everything. You will not be afraid. Somebody shout
amen.
Because light exposes any hidden item. Light exposes everything. See, if we turn off this
darkness,
you will not see what is here. But when you turn on this light, you will see it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. See, let me tell you something.
Hey,
when we used to be in the camp, sometimes we don't have this notice like in Canada. We are lucky in Canada because sometimes if you want to visit somebody, you let them know that you are coming. When I visited James in their house in the camp, you don't tell them that you're coming. We just show up.
Amen.
And I know they're in their room. And I'm saying, oh brother, I'm outside. But they take long to come out. Do you know why? We take long to come out. Because we took this time to fix things in the room. The house sometimes is dirty. We sweep the dust into the corner. Do you know why we put it in the corner? Because of the darkness there. Because of the darkness, the dust cannot be seen.
sanda.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But when the light comes,
lakini manduliji,
even the dirt in our life, in every corner, will be exposed. Somebody shout amen. So how does Jesus function at the light of our life? How does Jesus expose our hearts open? He exposes the reality of the devil in our life. And the Bible says, whoever does evil hates the light. Because in the light, everything will be exposed. And in the book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verse 13, the Bible says, everything exposed by the light becomes visible. For it is the light that makes everything visible. Shout amen. Jesus, because he is the light, and because of his goodness, he will expose our badness so we can see that it's really bad. So we can begin to fall in love with his light. The second characteristics of light, the light enlightens. Light enlightens.
Nur buwale.
Jesus is the only light.
Yesus al huwa nur al-wahid.
He only does not expose the evil that we see.
Yesus ma biksib al-huwa al-hajar batal bin-nabu al-barab.
But he also opens our hearts to see God.
Biyafta gulumna sa nashuf rabah.
He enlightens our mind.
Biyafta azham bitana.
And therefore, Jesus knows that the gods of this world has darkened our mind. But then he comes to enlighten our inner man. The soul of man. That's why the Bible says in the book of Ezekiel,
that
I will give you the heart of flesh and remove the heart of his stone. This heart of his stone can only come out when God exposes
us.